Okay, so today we are going to talk about bioenergy. Alright, so bioenergy is generated when biogas is generated, and biogas is generated by biomass plant. So let's start with biomass plant. Okay. Let's first start with what is a biomass. Basically, if you have watched art films or any Bollywood movies, or if you have watched or if you have went to any villages, there you have seen cow dung, right? So they used to dry it, and then they use the cow dung to produce heat, which they use for cooking food or lighting their or getting warmer during the winter, right? So this cow dung is basically your biomass, right? Like everything that is biometric and can be used, I mean can be dried and used for producing heat, is known as your biomass. So let's take cow dung as your example. So what does biomass plant does? In biomass plant, there is a digester. Okay, from here your biomass is fed. Okay, biomass, it is fed like here, and then this fills up the tank. Okay, this tank gets filled up. Okay, now here reaction occurs, and then these are the gases forms. Okay, there are four types of gases forms from this digester cabinet. Okay, the gases are methane, CO2, H2 and HS. Okay, these are the four gases that are formed, and then these gases are given out through the valve, and then they are given out through the outlet, and then these gases can be used to produce electricity or goes directly to your kitchen. Okay, this is the basic working cell of your biomass plant. Okay, so now this getting of gas can be done by two processes. One is known as your gasification, and the other one is known as your incineration. Okay, so by incineration we get the idea that there is something burning, right? There is something incinerating. Incinerating means burn. Okay, so we get the idea that here something is going to burn. But what about gasification? Okay, the both outcome is same, both will produce your gas, but what is the difference between them? All right, so in gasification, the main difference between these two is it produces gas by breaking the molecules of the biomass. Okay, this one breaks the molecules, all right? Suppose a biomass is given, and suppose I take another picture here. Suppose this is a picture, okay? And these are the biomass. In this part, oxidation is happening and then reduction is happening. There is a small outlet, okay? From here, the gas is produced and gas is given like this. And from this part, gas is given out. So at this portion, okay, at this, sorry, and about this portion, molecules are breaking and producing gas. Okay, like CO2, methane, H2, H2S. So basically gasification, what it does is it does the same thing. Okay, I mean this is basically, if question asks what is gasification, you can just give them this one. Just add one extra line that it breaks the molecules of the biomass. Okay, This gasification breaks the molecules of the biomass to produce gas, and then the gas is given out through the outlet or the valve to be used as desired. Okay, this is the work of gasification. Now, what is the difference between gasification and incineration? Right, as I said, incineration is burning. Here, nothing was burned, but here there will be burned. Okay, there will be incinerated. So, how does that work? Basically, what incineration is done is in your municipal solid waste, right? So, the full form or the question you'll get is what is municipal solid waste incineration plant? Okay, this is the question you'll get. Now, we all know what municipal solid waste are, right? These are the waste, the car junk or the bricks or the your home junk or the furnitures you throw away or the fridges you throw away, every kind of metallic junk or the wood junk or the solid junk, right? Every kind of junk that you throw away and that goes dump into the garbage area. This is another municipal waste. So in many places or in many movies you have seen that they collect bunch of this waste and they crisp it or they like break it into small part or they totally combine them to make a very small part and they take them somewhere. Okay, this is the only part you know, right? Like there is a crane that is taking up the car pieces metals or the broken car metals, they are squeezing it to make it a small very tight component and then they are just taking it. That's it, you guys know this, that's it. What happens after that? They take this part, like I'm gonna call it municipal solid waste. They take this municipal solid waste, this is the crane, right? This one is taking this municipal solid waste and it is dumping it into escalator type thing, right? Like this is going this way and this is going this way. Okay, it is dumping it here. Air is used. Okay, air is used to burn them. Okay, burning, b-u-r-n-i-n-g. okay, here air is used to burn them. My drawing is totally bad, I know that, but here the explanation, all right? Here the air burns the municipal solid waste, and when it burns it produces two things. One, ash. This is known as an ash collector. Okay, it is producing ash. This ash is going to the ash collector. And second thing, it is producing gas. Okay, all right. So it has produced a gas. This gas now same is given out through a valve. Okay, and then it is used to make electricity or whatever. Now there is also a small process between here that there is a gas filtration process that goes around somewhere here part. Okay, that is if the gas is not purely clean, because there are many gases which are not purely clean and they get purified and then they goes out. And due to this purification process, you have seen chimneys, right? In industry they give black smoke. This is the process due to that. Due to this filtration, due to the production of the gas, when they go out of the valve, they give this black ash and then they use the gas, okay, for future use. So, and yes, do remember this ash, the ash is collected, it is very dangerous ash, alright. So this ash must be collected properly. I mean, they shouldn't be dumped in the ground or in the water or anywhere. It should be collected very properly, the ash. Alright, because they're very dangerous ashes. So basically this is your biomass plant. Okay, to recall it all, the biomass plant, what happens is biomass is given to the digester. Their gasification or incineration, any one of the two things happens. Okay, and the gases are released, and the gases are used to and the gas is released from the valve, and then the gases are used for your kitchen or for producing electricity, or and the part that is not used for gas or the remaining part is given out as your manure. Okay, this one is known as manure. Okay, The part that is not used is given as manure, and the manure is rich in your nitrogen and phosphorus, so they can be used for farming purposes. Okay, so here are the manures, they are given. So basically this is your gasification and this is your incineration. All right, so in gasification, breaks the molecules. So I mean, these are a biomass, right? They are totally breakable. And in incineration, you cannot break it like that because they are solid waste, right? They are metal chunks, so you cannot break it like that. So you need to burn them. While burning them, gas produces, and it does, this one produces more, this one impacts environment more. This is more polluting, okay? More polluting compared to this one. Okay, so this one is more polluting. This municipal solid waste is crushed into a small size one, then they are given for burning to the furnace, and here it get burned to using air, and they produce gas. The gas is given for future use, and the ash is collected carefully. All right, so basically this was your biomass plant and gasification and incineration. Hope you guys understood the difference between them. If you guys did, then great. Like this video with not and subscribe with notifications on. See you guys in the next video.